The report is that they want to move on from him. This is a quarterback that is due $15.1 million in base salary last year, only played in four games. Now, granted, he didn't win any of them. I just don't think that that sample size is large enough to make a decision on a quarterback that just won a Super Bowl for Philadelphia. And if you're going to go forward with Gardner Minshew, you better be darn sure that you're not just getting caught up in what you see on Facebook and Instagram and all the, you know, cult hysteria about Gardner Minshew, because that's not going to pay you dividends in the win column if he's not for sure, for sure.
Yeah, I think it's fair. Listen, if I'm the Jaguars, I keep Nick Foles. But if they are going to move on from Nick Foles, the ideal team to call the Jacksonville Jaguars for a trade is the Chicago Bears.
Oh.
It's a great fit for them schematically, but it's also a great fit for a guy who knows his best role is being that mentor, that backup quarterback that helps a young player play as good as he possibly can. And then, man, you got to go play for two or three games, and he plays at a starter level. So if I'm the Chicago Bears, and this, there's any truth to this, that's my number one call.
I'm glad you're on the other side of the table, because I would keep him in Jacksonville. But if I was going to trade him, there's only one place in America. It's the Philadelphia Eagles. When they were together with Carson Wentz,
oh, no.
They won the Super Bowl.
Don't walk away.
What is wrong with winning the Super Bowl?
We're going to do this the second day in a row.
If we go by what we see, why would you not want to bring back a high-character, productive quarterback?
That gets along with the
Carson Wentz. And Carson Wentz, who was hurt in college.
Well, let me list out the reasons why.
Please.
Number one, you would undermine all the credibility and confidence that Carson Wentz built in that organization in locker room last year. Number two, you already have a daggum statue up for the guy that overshadows everything. Number three, how about instead of paying him that money, you go pay a wide receiver, since you had you playing wide receiver for them last year, or go pay a defensive back. The worst thing that the Eagles could do would go, hey, let's go bring Nick Foles back.
That Super Bowl
because those Philadelphia Eagles fans,
if he's this bravado, this alpha dog, he wants to bring in the best backup he can. And Carson Wentz was hurt in college. Carson Wentz was hurt in the pros. It's reasonable to think he's going to get hurt again. And if I'm the Philadelphia Eagles and I want to win a Super Bowl, you
Carson
can sit
Wentz
down there.
Started 16 games last year.
Yeah, he did, but he's been hurt twice.
No
why,
one.
Why not bring back the guy that you know fits really
because
well in that program?
Because you undermine everything that he built up last year.
Dan,
Carson Wentz doesn't want the best backup
I've been with.
Quarterback
when I was
available.
Around,
he wants good players around him.
Dan, the best quarterbacks I've been around, Brett Favre, bring them all in. They could all back
that's
me
right.
up.
Why, if you, right.
If you,
why would you be afraid of competition?
That's exactly.
That's not competition.
Why would you be afraid of competition?
There's no competition between them. There is no competition between Carson Wentz and Nick Foles. The last thing that Howie Roseman should do would be bring back Nick Foles, because that city still loves Nick Foles. He throws a pick, Carson Wentz throws a pick, you're going to hear boos and play card Nick Foles and whatnot, and all of a sudden you've got an issue. Don't bring issues, potential issues, into your locker.
Can I say one thing?
Yes.
We need to take a break.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports and analysis, download the ESPN app, and for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus.